In this video, I'm going to show you a couple of ways to protect your circuits from backwards power connections. So let's say you have a 12-volt power source, like a battery, and you want to power something. It doesn't matter what it is, let's just say it draws 2 amps. When the battery is connected the right way around, everything works fine. But if you've had a little too much to drink and you plug it in backwards, bam, your circuit blows up. The simplest way to protect yourself here is to use a diode. If the power is connected backwards, no current can flow through the diode, so your circuit is safe. But there's a downside to doing this. As you'll remember from my diode tutorial, the heat generated in a diode is given by the forward voltage times the current. So for example, with this 1N5401T diode, you've got a forward voltage drop of about 0.85 volts. 0.85 volts multiplied by 2 amps equals 1.7 watts of heat that you have to deal with, and that's pretty crappy. Now let's try to make that a little more efficient. Let's use a Schottky diode, which will give us a lower forward voltage. This STPS2L60 should do the trick. At 2 amps, it has a forward voltage of about 0.55 volts. The other reason why I chose this diode is because it has a low reverse leakage current of under 100 microamps. You have to be careful with Schottky diodes because a lot of them will have high reverse leakage currents of several milliamps, making them a bad choice for reverse voltage protection. Okay, let's do the math again. 0.55 volts times 2 amps equals 1.1 watts of heat. That's better than the 1.7 watts of heat that we had with the regular diode. But we can do even better, and not everyone knows this technique. First, get yourself a P-channel MOSFET, like this FQP47P06. Pay very close attention to which pins are gate, drain, and source. Next, put it in your circuit like this. Now when the battery is connected the right way around, the transistor will turn on, allowing current to flow through it. And when the battery is connected backwards, the transistor turns off and your circuit gets protected, so you can be as drunk and irresponsible as you want. This protection circuit is a lot more efficient, and I'll show you the numbers later in the video. First, let's talk about how it works. Let's do an analysis when the battery is connected the right way around. A P-channel MOSFET will turn on when the voltage between the gate and the source is around minus 4 volts, or more negative than that. The exact gate threshold voltage will depend on what MOSFET you're using. The MOSFET has a parasitic body diode, so when we first connect the battery, there'll be a small voltage drop across that diode. It'll be roughly a 1 volt drop. So 12 volts minus 1 volt means that the source pin is at 11 volts with respect to the circuit's ground. Now what about the gate voltage? Well, we connected the gate directly to the circuit's ground, so the gate voltage is 0. So, the voltage between the MOSFET's gate and source is 0 volts minus 11 volts, which is negative 11 volts. And like I said earlier, since this is a P-channel MOSFET, if VGS is negative 4 volts or less, the transistor will turn on. And once it's on, you don't have to worry about that parasitic diode anymore, because the resistance between drain and source drops to almost nothing. Now let's do an analysis where the battery is connected backwards. Since we're keeping the ground symbol in the same place, that means that this node in the circuit is 12 volts less than ground, so it's minus 12 volts. And just like before, the gate is at 0 volts. Now, you know the MOSFET is supposed to be off in this situation, because I told you so. But how do we prove it? Well, let's pretend for a second that the MOSFET is on. If the MOSFET is on, the resistance between drain and source is almost 0. So that means that the voltage at the source is going to be almost the same as the voltage at the drain. So we've got minus 12 volts at the source, assuming that the MOSFET is on. Now let's calculate VGS again. VGS is 0 volts minus minus 12 volts, so VGS is 12 volts. Wait a minute. VGS has to be minus 4 volts or less for the MOSFET to turn on. And we just calculated VGS to be plus 12 volts when the transistor's on. What we've got here is an impossible contradiction. So our initial assumption of the MOSFET being on has to be incorrect. So what this means is, when you've got the battery connected backwards, it's impossible for the P-channel MOSFET to turn on, so your circuit is safe. Now let's talk about the power loss in the circuit. Earlier I mentioned that when the transistor's on, the resistance between drain and source is almost nothing. But to be more accurate, the resistance is a parameter called RDS-on, and you can find it out from the transistor's datasheet. The exact value will vary depending on the gate voltage and temperature, But for the sake of simplicity, you can just estimate it with the maximum value they give you. So let's say it's 26 milliohms. When you have steady DC flowing through the MOSFET, the power loss is given by I squared R. So 2 amps times 2 amps times 26 milliohms equals 0.1 watts. That's 17 times less than what we had with the initial diode. So now you can design more efficient killing machines. Finally, I want to talk a little more about how to choose the right P-FET for your application. The first and most obvious thing is that the drain source voltage rating has to be higher than your power supply's voltage. In this video, I used a 12-volt battery, so 60 volts is more than enough. Next, you want RDS on to be as low as possible to minimize the resistive power losses. Finally, you need to pay very close attention to the maximum gate source voltage. One of the reasons why I chose the FQP47P06 for the video is that it has an unusually large gate source breakdown voltage range, plus or minus 25 volts. However, other MOSFETs may have a maximum gate source voltage of only 15 volts or less. So here's how you can get the P-FET to work with a higher voltage input. Let's say our input voltage is exactly 30 volts now. If we add a resistor and a 10-volt Zener diode to the circuit, now we can clamp the gate source voltage to a maximum of minus 10 volts. So now the transistor is safe. Something like this 1N5240 would do the trick. It doesn't have to be exactly a 10-volt Zener diode. Something in the 6-volt to 12-volt range would probably be fine depending on the MOSFET. Alright, you are now an expert at reverse voltage protection. Check out my other videos for more stuff about electronics.